Good morning, my dear friends. I have a wonderful message for you. The message is sin versus the blood of Jesus. Sin. What is the nature of sin? The true nature of sin in the service. The Holy God hates sin. What sin does to his children? Because sin deceives us. Sometimes we forget there is consequences to sin. You've been deceived. Another thing that sin deceives us, but sin brings disappointment because sin offers promises that cannot produce. And that is why most people today, they feel disappointed afterwards, they have sinned. Because they have nothing to show for except disappointment. Sin may give you temporary satisfaction. Otherwise, many people will not be living in sin. And I understand that because there is fun to sin. And because of it, many people today are practicing sin. But the fun is temporary. And short-lived, at some point, it wears away. Just think about it. All disappointment with all the temporary satisfaction sin offers, but at the end, you still remain empty. You feel like a loser because there's no profit in sin. The Bible says, the soul that has sinned shall die, and the wages of sin is dead. So you see, we must take sin seriously. Whatever sin offers, it offers you disappointment, it brings sickness, disease, death, and total death, total separation from the living God. Whatever sin offers is a short-term enjoyment and a long time punishment, because you cannot fix the problem with sin. Without the blood of Jesus, your sin remains. We are talking right now nothing but the blood of Jesus. We are living in the age sometimes we don't like to talk about the blood of Jesus, and yet if Jesus did not share his precious blood, there's no way we could have forgiveness of sins, and there's no way we can be saved. The blood of Jesus is the most important thing in our lives, because the Bible says in Hebrews chapter 9 verse 22, without shedding the blood, there is no forgiveness of sins. So you see, in the perfect, sinless, our blood of Jesus is everything that needed for complete cleansing from sin. There is healing in the blood of Jesus. There is deliverance in the blood of Jesus. And there is total victory over sin in the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus was shed for us. Today, may I submit to you today three important things about the blood of Jesus. First of all, the blood of Jesus satisfied God's wrath. The Bible says in Colossians chapter 1, verse 19 to 20, for it pleased the Father that in him, in Jesus, should all the fullness dwell, and having made peace through the blood of his cross, by him reconciled all things unto himself. Excuse me. By him I said, what are things to be on earth, or the things in heaven? Secondly, the blood of Jesus saves the sinner. In Ephesians chapter 1, verse 7 says, in whom we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of sins, according to the riches of his grace. Thirdly, the blood of Jesus satisfies the believer. The Bible says in Hebrews 13 verse 12, wherefore Jesus also, that he might sanctify the people with his own blood, suffered without the gate. You see, the blood of Jesus Christ is the most important thing in the world today. Thirdly, the blood of Jesus Christ secures the believer. In Ephesians chapter 1 verse 9 says, if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. You see, friend, there is nothing but the blood of Jesus. There's no way that you can be forgiven except through the blood of Jesus. And that is why the blood of Jesus was needed as the only atonement for the sins of the world. Apostle Paul said in Romans chapter 2 verse 24, Christ Jesus, whom God put as preparation by his blood to be received by faith. The word preparation means he satisfied the wrath of God. Without the blood of Jesus, we are not saved. So the message is, sin versus the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus is victorious over sin. When Jesus died on the cross, he wiped away all of our sins, our past sin, our present sin, even our future sin. We have not committed yet. Today, it will please God if you accept what his son did for us on the cross of Calvary more than 2,000 years ago. All you have to say, Lord Jesus, come into my heart, be my Lord, be my Savior. I believe you died for my sins, that you rose again. You are in heaven. When I die, I will be with you. In Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you, man. That's it, my dear friend. If you reject Satan today and reject his works and his poems and invite the Holy Spirit to come into you, he will help you to navigate this sinful world which we live. There is nothing like the blood of Jesus. There is a power in the blood of Jesus. Give your life to Jesus Christ today. Remain blessed in the mighty name of Jesus. Jesus is Lord. Amen.